Whoa! This explains it. Rihanna. Rihanna was the original pick by the NFL to do Super Bowl 53 right here in Atlanta, Georgia on February the 3rd. She turned them down. She turned them down because she didn't like the way, or she does like the way the NFL is handling Colin Kaepernick, who's been blackballed, by the way, from the NFL. And also, she doesn't like the fact that all these other NFL players who are kneeling and sitting during the national anthem in protest of social injustice, they've been ostracized. She didn't like that. So apparently, and this is all off the record, by the way, because it's not official, but it's all over the website here. It's all over the internet. And it says, she turned them down. Well, that explains it. Because if you go back about one or two videos ago, I did this thing, Terence's Road to the Super Bowl, I talked about this. I talked about why are they having Maroon 5 here in Atlanta, Georgia at halftime do that? Okay, Maroon 5 is from LA, right? You know, right here in Atlanta, Georgia, you got all these great artists. Yeah, you got Ludacris, you got Usher. They could have 2 Chainz. Well, maybe not. But they had all these people but they took Maroon 5. Well, and it turns out it's because Rihanna was their first choice and she said no. Well, good for her, all right? And this is the 4th consecutive year that's been a blatant protest, political protest involving the Super Bowl, all right? Last February, the Super Bowl was in Minnesota. And it turns out, you look at the internet, this is also something that has not been public record because this has been a private thing, but apparently Jay-Z was asked by the NFL to do halftime, and he turned him down because he was also upset with the way the NFL was handling all these players protesting during the national anthem. Well, good for Jay-Z, all right? And their little secret is he didn't want to freeze to death in Minnesota. Neither did I, which is why I didn't cover that Super Bowl. I've covered 30 of them, but Minnesota. And I know what you're saying. They got a dome, but you still got to go outside sometime. But then, the year before that, like I said, 4 times in a row now, we had this political thing. The year before that, in 2017, I was there at that one, the Super Bowl in Houston. You had Lady Gaga. Yeah, Lady Gaga. She had her own little protest during that, and it was subtle. It was subtle. I mean, she came out singing all these patriotic songs. One was, This Land Is Your Land, This Land Is My Land, from the da 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 da. And that was her own little subtle dig at the current administration when it comes to its silly immigration laws, all right? And then later on in that performance, she had this little thing involved with diversity, the little song about diversity. So she got them in there. She showed up. She did it. That was a great performance too. Then the year before that, another great performance. I was there too, 2016. That was in San Francisco, actually in Santa Clara, all right? Yeah, San Francisco Super Bowl, that's a long story. But at that one, you had Beyonce, and Beyonce came out with her firm stance behind Black Lives Matter, okay? She and her dancers came out there wearing all black and afros and black berets. It was awesome, okay? So Beyonce showed up, Lady Gaga showed up. Jay-Z didn't show up. Would have been better if he would have. And Rihanna, she's not showing up. It would have been nice for her to show up too. And for no other reason, if Rihanna would have shown up, we wouldn't have to see Maroon 5.